G'day everyone, it's Daniel here from GI Energy, just doing a quick video for you from our head office in Brisbane. And today I just want to talk to you briefly about Phono Solar. So I have to admit, before I go any further, Phono Solar are one of my favourite panels personally. I will try and keep this non-biased and stick to the facts, but I must admit I really do like them. We install a bunch of different panels, and if clients come to us requesting certain panels, then we can always access them and install them at a really cost-effective price. So you don't have to have Phono, we've got plenty of other panels on offer, but today I'm going to talk to you about Phono. I'm going to tell you why I actually personally believe they are one of the best options on the market. So why do I think that? Well, let's start with the manufacturer. So the parent company of Phono Solar is Sumec. Sumec have been around since the 1970s, I think it was 1978. They're a Fortune 500 company. The last time I checked, they were number 268 in that list of the Fortune 500, which means they're in the top 500 companies in the world for scale and profitability, as judged by Fortune magazine, which is a very credible source. They're also very diversified, which means they have divisions that build agricultural machinery, they have divisions that build power tools, parts for BMW and Mercedes cars, a subsidiary built the world's largest power plant, hydro power plant, the Three Gorges Dam in China. They build container chips. They're the number one exporter of textiles anywhere in the world. They have renewable energy, of course, with their solar panels. The list goes on and on. So they're a truly large, diversified company. Why is that important? Well, it's important because if you go back roughly 6 years from today and you have a look at the solar panel manufacturers that were on the list of Clean Energy Council accredited solar panels to be purchased in Australia, roughly 85% of those manufacturers are either no longer on that list or no longer trading at all. What that means is that unfortunately people that purchase panels from those manufacturers are probably going to have a pretty tough time getting warranties looked after. So having a really strong, really diversified brand like Sumec is the parent company for Phono Solar, I think offers a lot of value for an investment that typically, you know, people want these to work for the full warranty period of 25 years, which covers the performance of the panel. So I believe it's important to find a brand that is going to be around to back that. So that's number one, is who makes the panel. Secondly, the actual, I guess, technical makeup of the panel itself. So this, the one that we're looking at here, is the 330 watt twin plus module. They also do a 400 watt twin plus module, which is basically the same thing, just bigger, 72 cells instead of 60. They also do a slightly smaller wattage, 300 watt panel, which is outside of that twin plus range and is a little bit more cost effective. These two, the 330 and the 400, are by far the most volume for Phono, and certainly for us. And they kind of encapsulate everything that you want to see a modern solar panel encapsulate. So they're a mono perc cell, which incidentally that technology was developed at Sydney University. So they're monocrystalline, they're mono perc. They're also a split panel, and they're also split cells. Essentially, the three of those things, what does that mean to you? It means they're going to be more efficient, and it means that it's going to increase the tolerance to shade. So when you're looking at a modern solar panel, they're the three key things that you want a panel to have, and Phono Solar have all of those things. So please have a look at our articles about what mono perc means and what a split cell and a split panel actually means and what it does. But essentially, it encapsulates those three things. The only thing that is sort of starting to emerge that this doesn't do is a bifacial panel. But realistically, a bifacial panel is only really beneficial for people that have a lot of reflection from, let's say, a ground mount array with a white gravel underneath it, for example. So the technical makeup of the panel, in my opinion, ticks all the boxes. So that all obviously sounds great, but what does that really mean in the real world? Spec sheets are one thing, real results are another. So let's take a look at a system that was installed not too long ago on a home that we installed, that was a 6.3 kilowatt array with a Fronius inverter, so fairly typical size for a house. Let's check out those results now. So as you can see, this here is the November production, and we did 1,129.33 kilowatts in that month. That works out to 37.64 kilowatts per day. Now, to put that in some kind of perspective, this is a NearMaps report. NearMaps is software that allows you to place panels on roofs, and it gives you an approximate estimation of what your system should perform like. Now, there is more sophisticated software out there that would take other things into consideration, but as a general indication, this is a really good tool. So you can see here from the chart that was provided to the customer prior to them purchasing the system that in November it's expected to produce 28 kilowatts per day on average, and this system's actually averaged 37.64 kilowatts per day. That's a fairly significant increase on the expected amount. Now, just before we move past that, let's look into that a little bit further. November and December are the best months of production for solar energy throughout the year, regardless of the panel. So we've picked a really good month there to look at. But I think anybody that understands solar energy will understand that those numbers are extremely, extremely good, particularly for a panel that is not as expensive as a lot of others. And I'll get into that a little bit more in a second. The last thing that is important with a solar panel is the reliability. So how long is it going to last? How much is it going to degrade? And there's a really interesting report that you can find that we can put a link up for that comes from a company called DMVGL Engineering. And they release a reliability scorecard for PV modules every year, year on year. And essentially they test PV modules for how they're going to degrade and how reliable are they going to be over the years. In a nutshell, Phono Solar are always delivering well in those reports. In fact, a lot of the years they're top performers in many of the tests that they do. So once again, for a panel that is not as expensive as some of the other premium panels on the market, they're performing well, they've got a great background, and the reliability based on a third party engineering company with no skin in the game for one module or another ranks them really, really well. So again, for me, they tick a lot of boxes. Now, in the interest of being impartial, Phono Solar are not the best at everything. Their limited range in Australia means that they do only have three real modules. They move up in class in terms of wattage from time to time, but they really only have the 300, the 330, and the 400. If you compare that to some of the higher volume manufacturers that sell into Australia, you'll find that they do have a bigger range to choose from, which can be helpful from an installation point of view and also helpful for a customer if they like the brand and they want to shop in within that brand and within that range. So the range is reasonably limited. Secondly, Phono Solar, you may have never heard of them. Their branding in Australia is quite poor, frankly. The website, the AU website, is fairly limited with information. So the brand here in Australia is not the best. In addition to that, the testing, if you don't want to take our word for it and you want to go out and do your own research and have a look at the real life testing of a Phono Solar panel, it's not as easy to do as it would be for other more recognized brands who take part in things like Desert Knowledge Australia, which is probably the most popular one. As a consumer, you can jump online, Google search that, and check out the project where there's a number of different solar panels in Australia being independently tested and live results available to anybody who wants to look at them. Phono Solar didn't take part in that, which in my opinion is not a great selling point and doesn't really fit in with the rest of how great the panel is. In addition to that, if you really are looking for the best solar system, you might want to go for a more expensive panel, because there are some out there that will outperform it, even though frankly with our own testing Phono Solar appear to do as well, if not better, than a lot of the really more expensive brands. Effectively, if you wanted to go and buy the best solar system, you would probably look at something like SunPower or LG, maybe, are two names that spring to mind. Having said that, they are a lot more expensive. So if you're looking for a solar panel that ticks as many boxes as possible, cost being one of them, efficiency being another, reliability being another, and then having the safety of a really well-backed company to support your warranties if anything does go wrong, it's pretty difficult to look past Phono Solar. And I think a good testament to that is, I just got married a couple of weeks before making this video, And very recently, we installed a solar system on my brand new in-laws' new home. They asked me to install a system that I thought would deliver the best value for money and be reliable long-term. And we installed a 7.2 kilowatt Phono Solar and Phonos Primo 6 installation on their home. And I'm extremely happy to say that it's doing really well so far. Early days, but the early numbers are really, really good. And I think it's safe to say that if I got that one wrong, I would be in a world of pain for the rest of my days. So I genuinely do have a lot of confidence in this panel. I have a lot of confidence in the manufacturer. I'm not suggesting they're the only choice. We're more than happy to discuss any panel on the market. We install a huge range. We only list a few of the most popular ones on our website, but we install a huge range of panels, and our consultants in the offices are able to offer advice on any of those panels. And we can remain impartial because we don't have a warehouse full of Phono stock that we have to sell or that we have a higher margin in. So please get in touch if you want any other information. That's my honest opinion of Phono Solar. Some of this stuff is subjective, so please make your own minds up. But they're a panel that have a special place in my heart. I love them, and we'd love to hear from you so we can talk to you about this or any others. Thanks very much.